Gulf of Mexico oil spill is the largest marine oil spill in history, caused by an explosion on the deepwater Hodyar oil rig, located in the Gulf of Mexico, approximately 41 miles away off the coast of Louisiana.
He is responsible for this horrific disaster, and we will hold them fully accountable on behalf of the United States, as well as the people and communities victimized by this tragedy.
Every second, the world suffers a lot of water pollution. As the world, unfortunately, Kurdistan is also suffering water pollution problems. Kurdistan, which has three provinces, is located in north of Iraq.
First, we are going to talk about Soleimani. Soleimani water sources are Dukan and Darbandi Khan. Recently, Soleimani citizens are not happy with the color and the quality of the water. We have researched and found out that the water which the government gives is clean and appropriate. But because of the old pipelines, which are from 1980s, the water is being polluted. This is Dukan's dam. It is the main water supply for Soleimani. Dukan Lake pollutes in several ways. One way is the narrow passages of water in Shabadin's border, which is polluted by oil and some other chemical raw materials that goes into Dukan Lake.
And here is Erbil, which has the same problem. The main water supply of Erbil is Zeygoura, which has a lot of visitors from all over Iraq and outside the country. Visitors who go to the lake cause 43% of water pollution. Sewage from Erbil, Rania, and Qaladze that go into the lake cause another 70% of water pollution.
Finally, Duhok. Duhok's water supply is the dam of the Duhok, which is on the highway between Iraq-Turkey border. In this way, there is oil transportation 24/7 whether by truck or pipes. Unfortunately, sometimes accidents occur in this way that spills oil into the water, which causes 9% of Duhok's water pollution. Tourists who go to the Duhok's resorts cause 24% of water pollution. And finally, sewages from Duhok, Zaho, Amedi, and Akre cause another 31% of pollution.
So we decided to go to the bazaar and interview some businessmen and other people about water pollution.
I have a suggestion for solving Choman's water that goes into Shabadi's border, which have not got any services, such as bridge, and this polluted the water because it is the main road for trading and everyone goes through the water. My suggestion is building a bridge between the Iran-Iraq border in purpose of helping the people around there and to stop polluting the water.
As a Soleimani citizen, I think the quality and color of the water is bad.
I did not use this water for 7 years, and I am sure that this water is not appropriate even for shower, because it really has a bad quality and color.
The best solution for sewage is loading the sewage sludge into airtight tanks called anaerobic digesters. Here it is kept at 35 Celsius and mixed with bacteria to break it down. As the bacteria digest the sewage, methane is produced. The methane is piped into large engines which produce heat and electricity.
Another solution is to warn people about littering and throwing garbage into the water. We can do this by putting sign warnings in the resources. And also, the government can add strict rules to punish people who throw garbage into the water sources.
The final solution that we thought about is replacing the old pipeline with the new ones. This should reduce water pollution by 28% of Soleimani, and it will also reduce water pollution in the other two cities. We hope these solutions that we explained in this documentary will be provided for every city in Kurdistan, because it will make the water cleaner, and we need clean water for living, because water can affect everything.
So please, let us all keep our water sources clean for animals and for ourselves.
And thanks for those who keep our water source clean. So!
Responsible.